Happy Diwali! Today's NLP technique is about big chunk and small chunk sized communication. How was your day? Isn't such an innocent question? Yet, it caused so much havoc in Mary's life. Mary is one of my clients, of course, her name changed, but this was before she practiced NLP. Each day, Mary's husband would come home from work and she would ask him, "How was your day?" And each day, she would get a one-word answer. "Fine." "Good." "Frustrating." "Productive." She would continue, and after dozens of questions, Bob, her husband, felt like he was being interrogated. And then Bob, out of reciprocity, would ask her, "How was your day?" And she would tell him how it started, who she had lunch with, where did she go, what were the challenges she faced, and how she had overcome them or not. Two things would happen. Bob would either roll his eyes, signaling that he was tired of listening, or two, he would just leave the room for Mary to realize that she was just speaking to herself. Now, either of these scenarios sent Mary into a rage. She would ask, "Why didn't he care about me? Why doesn't he care about my day? Why is he so selfish?" Mary used to complain. Each week, it was a major issue. Something they didn't know how to fix within them until they had NLP coaching. Now, during my coaching, I informed Mary about chunk size of information that we as humans have unconscious preferences for. As in how we like to receive and how we like to give information. Now, I figured out quite quickly that Bob, Mary's husband, was more of a big chunk person, while Mary was a small chunk personality when it came to discussing about their day. Now, they weren't talking to each other in the same language because of these differences in the chunk size of information. Now, over the next week, I asked Mary to practice only delivering big chunk information to Bob when he asked her, "How was your day?" Now, it wasn't easy for Mary to do so. She wanted to talk about a lot of details with Bob, especially if something really juicy happened that day. She said that she felt like she was going to explode from within because she was not able to share the information, of course. Now, what I recommended was to chat with her friends. And before her husband came home from work, she also could probably write down a journal just to make sure she gets it out and does not explode, as she used to say. Now, this way it was easier for her to keep focused on her goal of delivering only big chunk information to Bob. Next week, she told her husband about chunk-sized information and then asked him, "Would you like big chunk or small chunk information each time you ask me, how is your day?" For 4 days, Bob kept on saying big chunk. And it was getting frustrating for Mary that she was not able to get any closer to her goal. And then finally on the fifth day, Bob came and grabbed 2 cups of coffee that he made himself and said, "Mary, let's go and sit into the balcony. Today, I want to hear small chunk." While Mary told him about her day, he didn't roll his eyes this time. He didn't leave either. He listened and got engaged in the conversation. And he did it because it was his choice to listen to small chunk information. Now, They have been doing this for quite some time after that. And sometimes Mary says that when stuff gets really busy, they might forget this kind of behavior, and sometimes it does trigger some trouble. Though Mary did say that in stressful times, she goes back only to his way, and she goes back to her way, and he goes back to his way of communication. But fortunately, knowing this, they can always come back. They always come back and apologize to each other with no hard feelings. And that's the positive part of knowing this technique. Now, it seems that it seems to be a trivial thing. Often in relationships, it's these trivial things that make the difference. Had we not fixed this problem, they would have had days, weeks, months, and years of compounding unhappiness. Each of them would resent for not getting their needs met, and potentially would have looked at the relationship and said, well, this is too hard. This is not working. What's going wrong? Thankfully, in Mary's and Bob's case, this did not happen. In my next video, I'm going to touch on negative internal dialogue and how one of my clients used to die every day, in her mind, of course. So if you have a nasty voice in your head that just won't give you a break, stay tuned for my next video. Happy Diwali.